The thrill of watching a brilliant Indian movie at a monstrous international film festival by a female filmmaker and then having the chance to do this. Women telling women stories. Sorry, this chair doesn't have wheels. I can't do that. More Kiran Rao any day, please. Hey all, I'm Sucharita. Welcome back to my channel where we've got a bunch of TIFF coverage still slowly going on. Aaj, let's talk about another one that did very well at the festival, Kiran Rao's Lapata Ladies, starring a galore of incredible, fresh faces.
Bahut sundar hai, bhai.
The year is 2001. Setting is Nirmal Pradesh. A rather gloomy, bewildered young lady named Phool is being sent off from her maika to Sasural. Her equally youthful husband, Deepu, appears more cheerful, eager to take his new bride home. Off they go on a train, his face beaming, hers concealed beneath a long ghungat. Traveling in the general compartment, they sit next to another newlywed couple and the conversation flows, discussing ki kisko dahej mein kitna mila, while the two new brides brace themselves for a terrifying plunge into a future ruled by advanced laws and new bosses. Except in ki destinations hoti hain cross, both the men reach their homes, the women not so much. Kho gayi, bhag gayi, agwa ho gayi.
Par rasta mein iski biwi kho gayi sir.
Adapted from a story by Biplab Goswami with a screenplay and dialogue by Sneha Desai, the film crafts the North Indian village that serves as its backdrop with love and a gentle touch. Every room in every house, every sari worn beneath hand-knitted or locally bought cardigans, from the mix-and-match teacups to the sleeping carts, the scenery designed by production designer Vikram Singh comes alive with acute attention to detail. Open verandas of the village houses standing sunlit in stark contrast with the windowless rooms within. But not stopping merely at the cosmetic, Lapata Ladies dips its fingers into this jar of homemade desi ghee, molding out of it characters so authentic. I felt like I was watching my own aunt in actor Geeta Agrawal Sharma and every slimy, unreliable, corrupt police officer in Ravi Kishan. Seasoned actors aside, Lapata Ladies' strength lies in its young cast. Absolute finds by casting director Romil Modi. Like Thank You For Coming, jiska TIFF review you can watch here or here. Lapata Ladies also casts a social media influencer, but unlike the previous one, Nitanshi Goyal here has been given enough room to perform. In fact, she carries a lot of weight on her inexperienced shoulders. The actor has over 10 million Instagram followers. I had not one clue, our digital paths never having crossed. Her interpretation of Phool's journey from innocence to slightly more aware innocence makes your heart melt. Her simple-minded approach to life making you want to shield her from harm. Nitanshi is lovely, very likable, talented, standing out in a crowd despite her character designed to become lost in it. 24-year-old Sparsh Srivastav leads the cast with the emotional maturity of someone way beyond his years. Or maybe I'm just projecting because by God, at 24, I was an idiot. You start off by disliking Deepak just as much as the system that has created an atmosphere where such young people are forcefully married to each other. But by the end of the film, the actor so very clearly stands heads and shoulders above the rest, a stupendous find. Not because cinematographer Vikash Naulakha has framed him in any special ways or flattering lighting. It's just due to the sheer force with which the actor believes in the film he's in and the apparent hunger to justify his presence in this production. Very, very good. Now, while I wish Pratibha Ranta's extra tanned look didn't seem like brown face so much, in her character Jaya lies the true heart of the writing. A woman given an unexpected chance due to a twist of fate, and yet every second of every day she lives under the fear of that being taken away. Jaya is a rare human in this entire landscape, allowing herself the luxury of momentary relaxation as she devises a plan and hunts for an escape route before diving back into the chaos. You know, when women tell stories of women beating the odds, big or small, we think of those who paved the way, came before us. Each step forward is built upon the foundation laid by someone else. As Kiran Rao mentioned in our interview, which you can check out here or here, she introduces a character into this narrative, Manju Mai, played by Chhaya Kadam. Manju ek station pa chai bechti hai and is benefactor to many who live on the station. Just by the simple act of allowing Phool to sit on the bench by her tea shop, Manju saves that little lost girl from the worst fate imaginable. But Manju is harsh. She has had to clear paths for herself and like any krantikari, she knows the way to bring about change is not easy. Usko kisi ne feminism nahi sikhaya, lekin itna janti hai ki aage kisi ki life bachani hai, to is fraud scheme ke bare mein awareness lane. बतानी होगी व्हेन वुमेन्स वर्थ इज पेग्ड टू द यूटिलिटी दे हैव अराउंड द हाउसहोल्ड. इट इज अ वंडरफुल ओड टू मदर्स एंड ग्रैंडमदर्स हु स्टूड इन द वे एंड टुक द ब्लोज, अ काइंड ऑफ हार्ड वर्क दैट डजंट पे डिविडेंड्स ड्यूरिंग मोस्ट ऑफ देयर लाइफ टाइम्स. थ्रू मंजू लापता लेडीज टेक्स वन हार्ड लुक फ्रॉम अ डिस्टेंस एट द इंस्टीट्यूशन ऑफ पेट्रियार्की एंड देन स्लोली बट स्टेडली मूव्स क्लोजर टू पुल द कर्टन्स बैक एंड शो यू द फ्रेलिटी ऑफ इट्स आउटडेटेड ट्रेडिशंस. व्हाई दे वांट टू कीप वुमेन हिडन अवे एंड व्हाट हैपेंस व्हेन वी फाइंड ईच अदर आर कलेक्टिव विल पावर threatening the very tenets of this fraud scheme. It is a simple enough truth addressed by the film rather simply as well. Ample of humor and sweet moments to make the medicine go down.
Does it occasionally lean towards simplistic?
Sure. But does that detract from the overall experience of the film? Not really. So, on a scale of 1 to 10, Lapata Ladies is... One dialogue seems like a translation of something we'd heard a filmmaker say in an interview not so long ago. Jo pyar kare hai, uka marne ka hak hota hai. I swear, it almost felt like the character was saying it, breaking the fourth wall, delivering the lines straight to you through the camera, and then slowly shaking their head in silence. The film is out on 5th of January. Dekhkar batana if you catch it. Two movies, huh? This... TIFF 2023 set on a train, which I liked very much. Kill ka review dekha hai. Interviews bhi hai bahut saare. So check it out. My name is Sucharita. Thank you for stopping by.